Natalie Imbruglia built her career on Neighbours at the age of 16 before ascending to Australian music royalty. Her debut single, Torn, was a massive worldwide hit, and her US top 10 album, Left of the Middle, sold over 6.5 million copies. She's won a swag of awards, starred on film alongside Rowan Atkinson, and in the Australian drama Closed for Winter, all the while dedicating herself to charities and causes close to her heart. Now she's back with Want, the single she wrote with Coldplay's Chris Martin from her fourth studio album, Come to Life.
Please welcome back to the show, Natalie Imbruglia. Hope you get all that you want.
That's very good.
Because I did it.
Even did that bit.
That's really
good. Where have you been? We've missed you.
I know. I've been working hard on a record that's spanned far too many years.
And now you're here, thank goodness.
Yeah.
Are you okay? Everything's fine.
Everything's good.
Good.
I've got a new record company, a new album, and I'm single, and life's good.
Hello.
Hello.
Now, did everyone think this was going to be a breakup album, this one? That was this weird expectation
that everyone kind of went, oh, it'll be really personal, all that sort of stuff.
Well, I have been doing interviews and that seems to be the gist of it. But, you know, I can't help that kind of happened in the middle of the whole process of the record, so it's not a breakup album.
But if also the single Want, for all it's about, you didn't write that. Because is that the one Chris Martin wrote? Or helped write?
Well, it's a rewrite of a song that I had, so he helped me rework it. So that one is a co-write, but the song called Fun, he wrote for me.
So what's it like working with Chris Martin?
Amazing.
I heard he made you cry.
Well, they kind of exaggerated a little bit. He didn't make me cry, but I asked him to be brutally honest about the songs.
Never do that.
And he was. So he was like, that one's terrible, get rid of that one. That one's great. No, I don't like that one. So, yeah, there was a bit of a kind of, you know, when you've lived with these songs for ages, it was like a little bit hard to hear.
From Chris Martin, of all people.
Yeah.
That's what
But it's good that he was honest, I think.
Did you get to return serve?
No. No.
That's not
fair. I didn't comment on any of his songs, but I got to hear little bits of the new things.
Now, this is what I find interesting, because he says the single that he's given you, it's almost like he's given away the best Coldplay song, is the way he's described
it. He's good, isn't he?
That's what you want.
That's good PR.
But is it... It's different if you're, you know, if you're someone who's not performing anymore, but if you've still got a band, you're still doing well, how is it that you get together and collaborate and find that these people are happy to give up songs like that?
I don't know. I don't know. But we don't want him to think about it too much because he might want to take it back. he just got in touch with my lawyer because he didn't know how to get a hold of me. He doesn't have my number or anything. So we have the same lawyer firm. So he got in touch with me and said, I've got this idea that I'm working on. And then I met up with him and he took my album home, and that was a long 24 hours because I thought, oh, my God, he's going to hear it and change his mind. And then he loved it and he finished off an idea after hearing the record, which is why a lot of people maybe think it sounds like something that I wrote. Ah. But he wrote it with me in mind after hearing the album.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, that's why it's so fitting.
And are you enjoying single life? For all the, you know, ups and downs that obviously have to get you there.
I am. I'm loving it.
Are you trying to kill yourself? Because you're going out and doing all this, not in that way, but you've just gone extreme Imbruglia.
I know. It's really weird.
What are you doing? All this adventure stuff you're doing. Run me through it.
Well, I went on Adrenaline Junkie, which is a show that Jack Osborne hosts. And you go off and do all these mad things. And I'm just fearless. I don't know. I was like, yeah, I'll climb a mountain. Yeah, I'll bungee jump off that big mountain. And so I did all these crazy things. I did free diving and I dove to 80 feet.
So free diving is no tank?
No tank.
You just hold your breath?
Yeah. Yeah. And they teach you a technique. So you lie on your back and you breathe for like 5 minutes. That's the boring bit. And then you take a really deep breath and you go down this rope.
For how long?
Well, I did 4 minutes underwater.
You but can't, when you die.
I didn't die, I'm here. I'm a ghost!
I knew it!
When you actually go down the rope, though, you don't make it to the 4 minutes. So I did 80 feet in probably about 2 minutes.
That's crazy talk.
Yeah.
And then you're climbing mountains as well.
Yeah, Mount Fable in Calgary, in Canada.
Now, that one is like... That's not like just like yodelay, yodelay, hee-hoo thing. This is like climbing up with ropes and...
I had no
idea.
How long
did it take?
I did 2 hours training and I had these fancy little rock climbing shoes and they never came out of my bag because the mountain was wet. And I don't know if any of you rock climb, but you can't rock climb a wet mountain with, like, I had trainers on. And I was climbing in snow, and it's straight up with some overhangs, which is where you're actually climbing backwards. I had 3 meltdowns. I begged them to rescue me. They didn't explain it properly. It wasn't in the contract.
How long did it take you to get up there?
11 hours.
11 hours?
And I got stuck in an electrical snowstorm as well. About half an hour from the summit. I was like, yes, there's a cross. I don't know. Oh, that was a bit
scary. How do you wee? In 11 hours?
I held in a wee for 11 hours. I love Australia.
Oh,
I love it.
Isn't it great to be back on the market? Hey, Natalie, are you ready for your public pro?
Are you going to ask me about Prince Harry? No?
Are you doing it?
No, I'm not. Am I doing
it? Prince Harry, you and Prince Harry.
No, but I'm shocked that you haven't asked me because
everyone else wants to know. Okay, stop. Public probe. I'll probe first. So you and Prince Harry, discuss. Have you kissed him on the face?
I haven't kissed him at all.
Have you hung out?
I've met him once for about 2 minutes and then I was at the Killers gig side stage and he rocked up and was like, hey, and I was like, hey, Harry. How you doing? And that was it. And so, yeah. So apparently that's where the rumour started from.
Wow. But, you know, that's a good family to get in on because they're fine.
I don't think they'd accept me.
But have you hung out? Like, have you gone out socially other than that, though?
No.
Well, then how does that start as a rumour?
That's what I'm saying to you. Literally, he was at my birthday party and I met him very briefly. And then I was side stage at the Killers gig. Didn't arrive with him or anything. And people saw us saying hello to each other. And it's all come from that.
Do you know who
because
I think?
He's a prince.
No. Harry.
What you thinking?
He's gone off and he's gone, me and Imbruglia. Yeah.
Possibly.
The same thing happened at my 30th. Camilla was at my 30th. People started talking. It happens.
That's it. That's true. And you only met the once.
That beard.
I know. He's a proper actor now, don't you know?
Oh, really?
Yes. All right, Natalie, let's properly get publicly probed.
Okay.
Number 5 from Brad in South Caulfield, Victoria. Well, this is an interesting follow-on. Is it true you based your last music video on a party you once had with Prince Harry?
No.
Damn it.
If anything, it was my birthday party it could have been based on. But was it was a fancy dress party.
There's people lying around, they're all trash, they're all... Richard Branson's son
friends.
Is there.
Because half of the people in that video sang on that track, which is called Wild About It. You can see it online. I thought it was only
fair...
We've
got some of it here, actually. We've got some of it.
Oh, have you?
It's just... we don't. Don't worry about it.
But I thought it would be...
I accidentally taped over it. I'm sorry.
So, yeah, the people who were in the video sang on the track.
Oh, okay.
You can hear lots of drunk people in the song. Anyway.
It would look like a fun karaoke night. I would have liked it. Number 4 from Nick and Dianella WA. What's the weirdest rumour you've ever read about yourself in the paper? This is a ripper tonight.
Apart from the Prince Harry thing, but that's not so weird. That's just not true. I would say that they thought I was kidnapped and I had to ring my mum and tell her I haven't been kidnapped. Because I was coming out of a club with my lawyer who missed the whole thing. Somebody picked me up, spun me around, my backside touched the boot of someone's car and I was going, whoa, what's going on? And then I stood up. It all was in 2 seconds, but they got a picture of me looking like I was being thrown in a car. And then I was, like, screaming out to my lawyer, I just nearly got kidnapped. And he's like, what? And he missed the whole thing.
Dude, you got to get a new lawyer. I thought you were going to say, I met a kidnapper once, and all of a sudden... OK, Jasmine from Woi Woi, New South Wales, near your part of town. You once worked with Tom Jones. Were you tempted to throw your undies at him?
No.
Number 2 from Tegan in Ulverstone, Tasmania. When you get angry on the road, are you a honker, swearer or a rude gesturer?
Probably all 3.
Nice.
Yeah.
And finally, from Shane in Morayfield, Queensland, number 1, if you got drunk, would you dance on tables naked?
Not naked, but I dance on tables.
That's what I'm talking about!
You're wonderful. You can find Natalie's latest single, Want, Don't Make Me Sing It, on a new album, Come to Life, which is out October 9. So here's a pretend version of it now. She'll be keeping us company for the night, but thank you for now. Natalie Imbruglia, everybody. Thank you.